under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
And okay, can we have, first I'd like to start off with roll call.
Lori.
Here.
Jesse.
Here.
Dan.
Here.
Deb.
Here.
George.
Here.
Pam.
Here.
Okay. And I would like to bring some guidelines to the meeting. If you wish to speak, please stand up and be recognized and state your name. And once you're recognized, you have 2 minutes to address the council. Please do not interrupt the council's discussion on a topic. Once again, if you have any information or question to ask, just stand up and then we'll recognize you. Okay, can we have a committee report?
Lights.
They're all working.
Okay, streets.
The streets are pretty much what you would expect when since they're under construction. If anybody's been in a construction zone, you know that it settles, and we're keeping up on it as best that we can. Elite Construction is doing awesome. Some of the residents are helping out too, being very positive about it. They understand they've been in construction before, so we just got to tough it out for a few more months till they're done. Then they'll be as good or better than before.
Catch basins?
They're working. I still got to go around and clean some of the gravel and dirt out of the catch basins though. I forgot the past month.
Signs?
Everything's still, yeah, the same. There's going to be a little bit of a change in the size of the signs, because after looking at them, they're not as big as what they were, so it's going to be less. And I'm kind of holding off until I go to that class to see about the placement and everything else at the 24th of this month, and then I will know more. Reordering the signs and ordering the new ones.
Right.
And I have the check for your classes. I'll send that out today.
Okay.
Cemetery?
Nothing new to report. There'll be some cleanup with some branches and from all the winds, but other than that.
Safety?
Police department hours for February 2016. Officers, J.J. Benninger had 12.25 hours. Mike Benninger, no hours. Marty Finch, no hours. James Hauser, no hours. Tim Norris, no hours. Stephen Rice, no hours. Ray Scott had 49.70 hours. Ray Snain, no hours. And Corey Seagrove, 61.95 hours for the month. Total mileage for the month was 134. There were 6 tickets written for the month, and one assist call. There was 2 calls, no arrests and no summons.
Tim Norris, I'm sorry, Tim Norris, I'm pretty sure resigned last month. JJ? Did Tim Norris resign last
night? Yes, Tim Norris retired.
Okay. Okay, I'm going to switch and go to new business right now. Mr. Hawk is here from Rita, and he would like to, he has a presentation. It's going to take like 15 minutes. So if you'd like, you can come out.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Excuse me. First off, I want to thank you for giving me the opportunity to be here.
I get some business cards here. My name is Charles Hawk. I'm the marketing specialist for Rita, and I'm thankful that you guys have been supporting us for the last few years. Actually, you guys actually came on board in 2011, and just to give you a little history, at that time, we came out here, and actually I was the gentleman that actually came out here and presented a projection to you. What I'd like to do is go over some of the information we have here. I only have 9 of them, so you're going to have to share.
Okay.
But I'll go through this whole thing fairly quick, and then also I'll share with you some other information.
Hey.
So actually, back in 2010, I was approached by your mayor at that time. I believe it was Mayor Cole. Mm-hmm. And she invited me to come out. I gave a presentation. We did a projection for folks. At that time, the projection that I gave was approximately $14,000 for your community. It takes probably about 3 years to realize the total amount. And actually, you folks realized that total amount within the second year, which was pretty good. And what I wanted to do is kind of go over the handouts that that I put out. It's a memo. First off, when we bring on resources or bringing on additional taxpayers, resources we use is such as the state tape, the federal tax information, W-2 information, and we use all that information. We cross-reference. So when I'm throwing these numbers out, this is where we're getting that data. So for example, in 2012, you brought on 21 new accounts, meaning we brought on possible taxpayers from this database. 2013 was 11, 14 with 9 new accounts, 15 was 6. Now, again, this is from the state tape information, which is the database that we get, we purchase, IRS information, W-2 information, and also surrounding communities that we have business with, that we cross-reference those W-2. So somebody's working in one of our communities, we cross-reference and checking that data. So that's how we bring on. So any type of information we get from the city, you know, such as water bills, sewer bills, any type of stuff like that, get it over to us. We have a full-time registration department that also assists in this as well. So if you have that database, get it over to us, talk to us, and we can help you with that. So that's something that we do, and this is ongoing. E-filing, again, we're trying to get more and more people to e-file. We're trying to get away from the paper. It makes sense. It really does. Last year, or 2 years ago, 2012, we had 18 filings of e-file. In 13, we had 32. In 14, 34. And in 15, 38. Again, we keep pushing that. So anytime you can make reference on your website or on your cable, whatever you have, the website indicating Rita, and you can file online, that goes a long way. You get your money quicker. It makes it easier for people to file a return, and that's a nice process we do provide. Going on to the tax collections here, again, in 2012, we were very fortunate. We collected over $13,000 for you folks. In that was in 12. 13, we spiked a little bit at 17. In 14, we went down a little bit, about 12. And then recently in 15, we're back up to almost 14 again. So it's pretty steady. It really is. But again, if you keep giving us information, that gives us an opportunity to follow up.
Okay.
Going on to the back side, we talk about the delinquent program. Last year, you folks ran a subpoena or a delinquent program. Again, we're going after the non-filers. You just participated in the letter program. Didn't cost you anything. What we did from that, we identified approximately 26 delinquent filers, of which we identified almost 2,000 in liabilities, and we collected 1,600. So that's not bad. We're right. Continuously doing that. Keep fitting us information. We can follow up on that. The FTI program, again, this happened in last year in 15. We identified about $3,000, and that's ongoing. We keep on bringing on more and more community, or more and more money through that program. Now, going on to the next section that we have there, we're going into the tax filing season. And what I did was I put together on our website, you can go out on our website, RitaOhio.com, there's taxpayer assistance, help taxpayers out. This is something that maybe you can put on your website, you know, referring to this, how they can go on there, how they can file, that type of thing. So that's important. Going on to the next section, we talk about customer service. phone lines. We have extended phone hours, actually for the pretty much for the from February 22nd to March 24th. Mondays and Thursdays, we're open until 6 o'clock. So you can call us up and talk to a taxpayer or a customer service rep, and they can help you through the tax return. We also have extended hours on Saturdays. We're open on Saturdays, and it's just unbelievable what we are. We're open for the whole month of April, and then actually, obviously, the latter part of March, so next Saturday, actually. So we're open, and we have continued hours so people can get out and see us. Going on to the next page, we talk about taking care of walk-in taxpayer assistance. We have actually 9 different locations throughout the state that you can go to. Actually, go to our facility in Brecksville. It's an hour away. I realize that's a little bit of a run, but people can come out there. If they want to talk to somebody, they can actually see somebody and then do that as well. And then finally, for those people that are attempting to file the returns and that kind of thing, we just recently instituted videos on how to fill out the returns. They're really nice informational videos. It kind of helps you through the process, and it works out very, very well. Another thing that I was talking to your fiscal officer about is we have what is called a TAP agreement, and what it is basically you get access to the system. And I've actually got some information from her now. And what we'd like to do is eventually give her the ability to use this information. This is a dashboard report. And what this is it'll kind of basically tell you what your community is doing at this time. And it'll actually, this is something that'll be a nice little tool to have, and she can use this at any time. There's no additional cost for that, but we need her to follow up and get that TAP agreement and get it rolling. She could probably have it up and running probably within the next couple of weeks. But actually, I would come out and teach her how to use the system. Okay. That's what we do. I just wanted to give you like a nutshell what we've done the last few years for you folks. And I'd like just to open it up to questions from the audience as well as council.
Does anyone have any questions?
I don't understand what the Rita's tax is paying for. Like, all I know is it's coming out of my check at the end of the year.
Okay, Rita tax is a municipal income tax, and it's primarily, there's two taxes in Ohio. There's the workplace city tax. People call it the Rita tax, but it's not. It's wherever you work, you pay a tax. I work in Brecksville. I have 2% taken out, okay? I also live in Strongsville. I pay Rita because I live there. I pay an additional 0.5%. So I pay that additional money. That money, first off, the workplace city goes to the work. There's no reciprocity. There's no sharing of money. Then the second part of it goes to the resident. In my case, it's Strongsville. I pay that 0.5%, and they pay it on a quarterly basis. In my case, my employer takes it out, so that additional 0.5% is taken out. So basically, that's what it is. It's local municipal income tax.
But what is it being used for?
That's up to whatever the municipality chooses to do with it. It's in their charter. It's in their ordinance. Sometimes, depending on your situation, your solicitor can tell you that. You know, it may be for streets. It could be roads. It could be for police protection. It could be many things.
So it is being put in.
Into a general fund, yes.
For this community.
Yes, absolutely. Okay. Good question.
Okay, does anybody else have any questions?
Mr. Hawk, is there a credit this year if you live here and work in another?
I don't know what the tax, I believe your tax rate is 1% with no credit. So that means.
Correct.
Yeah, so if you don't, so it doesn't matter if you work in Mansfield to have money taken out, you're still going to owe the 1% here.
Same as all the other years, Freddie.
Yeah. Well, the 86-page ordinance, I was wondering if it changed anything.
That was just so we'd stay compliant.
For HB 5?
Yes.
Yeah, exactly. By the way, we helped you with that as well, so we kind of gave you some model ordinance, and I know your solicitor used that, so that was a great tool to have. And then as time goes on, that thing's going to change, so we'll keep everybody abreast of what's going on with that as well.
In fact, if we would not have been compliant, nothing would have changed. We just wouldn't have been compliant.
Right, you would have never been able to collect the tax. Right.
I have a question.
Yes.
I didn't know I had to pay. Like when I asked Worcester to take it out, they wouldn't, but they said that I should get a tax credit because I'm paying the 1.5 over there. So there is no tax credit?
And I'm not sure, why wouldn't the employer take out your...
They will not take out for anything.
Mine won't either.
Say it's an additional cost to them, and they won't.
Really?
Not all of them do. There's a special code that they have to look up to use.
I know, it's heavy, so hard.
Yeah.
Mine wouldn't either.
Mine don't either, or my husband's.
Okay.
I know a lot of postal people that they'll take that out of their credit union. And at the end of the year, they pay on a quarterly basis, and they make sure that everything's paid up by the year end. So that might be an option for you,
What's
too.
That?
Have the money taken out, whatever that dollar is for Worcester, take it out into a credit union, and then at the end of the year, you just pay them off.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
Okay.
What's your name, ma'am?
Charlotte Hatfield.
I have one more question. So I got a bill from Rita, and I paid it.
Yes.
Which was based off of last year.
Right.
But I didn't make as much as I did last year. So when I go into file, am I going to get a credit?
Yes, you will. Or a refund. Okay, what we'll do is we'll reconcile that return.
Okay.
And then it'll indicate whatever it is. So if we owe you $50, then we will pay you that to you. Or we will credit you. So your next quarter, you'll owe less money, that type of thing. But you can change that any time. Just call up and they can help you with that and change that estimated during the year, as many times as you want.
Okay.
Question. I only work in the summertime.
Okay.
So my estimated is always, always terribly messed up.
Just call us up and tell them that, and tell them what did you make at that time? What was your year-to-date earnings? So if you made $5,000 and you were consulting or whatever you were doing, then you were just owed for that period of time.
Well, the rest of my income is retirement.
Right, that's not taxable.
So it's not on, but it's to transfer from line such and such of your federal tax form doesn't work for me because it's income there, but it's not here.
Right.
But I will say that when I got the opposite of what she did, I called in some lady over there, walked me through each line and got it all straightened out. So it worked out. It's just been, it's almost impossible to get the estimated regulated. Even though I make basically the same thing every summer, it still gets goofed up.
I would suggest you probably do that as soon as possible. Change that estimate, whatever that dollar amount is. Give them a call, tell them what it is, and they'll tell you what that estimate's going
to
be.
Well, we got to the point where we just pay it at the end of the year. That way we're messing around.
That's fine. That's fine.
I thought it had to be paid quarterly.
Well, it is, but the rule is you got to have 90% paid in full by year end. That's how your ordinance reads. So if you're disciplined enough to wait to the end of the year, you pay it in full, it's not a problem. It's just when you don't pay it in full, that's when you get assessed.
Oh, okay.
What's your name? I'm sorry.
Dillian DeLaRosa.
Okay, thank you. Does anybody else have any questions for Mr. Hall? Okay.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Yes.
Okay. We're going to go to old business. And we have Jason here. And he's going to give us the sewer project update.
We are having the tanks actually brought in this coming week. We're going to mobilize back in, start installing those in the ground up there, and start building the building for the treatment plant. Ohio Edison is kind of moving at their pace, I guess. They're not planning on having it, the power to it, somewhere around late May, maybe early June. Once we get power to that wastewater treatment plant, there's some things that they have to do to get it up and running, ready for you guys, for us to hook in so that they can actually take sewer. So once that treatment plant's up and running, we will actually come back and hook up everybody's. We'll crush your tank, suck it out, crush it, and hook you up completely. And then that's when we will actually seed and straw and take care of everything. Depending on Ohio Edison, when they give me their actual schedule, we would like to try to get everything out of the roadway. So once these asphalt plants do open up, we can go ahead and take care of your guys' roads, get them back, and it would just be the grass areas that we'd have an issue with. So I don't have an actual schedule yet until Ohio Edison gets on and starts bringing the power up to us.
So you're telling me it's going to be June before you're back in my yard to finish?
I would say that would be the earliest. Now we can come through.
I understand the construction thing, but I've got my dog fence has been torn up and ripped in 6 different places and patched and goes off and everything. So I'm just trying to figure out how to resolve that for another 4 months.
We can come back and level out your yards. We won't actually see now if there's an issue with your dog fence. We'll just have to come and we'll take care of it. If we tore it up, we'll fix it.
Well, what I'm saying is it loses its continuity or something every time it gets like the heavy wet snow would bury it in the dirt. And today when it was raining the hardest, it started beeping again. And then you got to go down physically reset it, and then it's set way too high for the dog just to keep it functioning right now.
So it's probably been hit and it's grounding out to the when the ground gets moisture.
Oh, it got cut 6 or 7 times just laying on top of the ground because every time we went through there, we tore it up and we just left it that way because they were going to be back first thing in the spring. That's why.
Right. Well, I mean, we can get a new line to come across there, so you only have 2 points that get in contact. It's just something we'll have to look at and we can take care of.
Okay. I've already done this after they cut it. And I didn't have any more left. I went and got 2 more spools. So but it's laying across my yard in one section. I can't leave it lay there and mow.
Right. So I'm telling you that we'll come and we'll take care of it and fix it to your liking. I mean, I don't know what other...
Because, well, the point is when they track back in there to do...
We will tear it up probably again.
Right.
Right.
So now it's...
And then they'll fix it again.
Exactly. It's the process of what we have to do as this is drawn up and how we have to build it. I mean, I really don't have another answer for you.
No, I've just been fighting with it ever since I tore it up and leaving it go because it was going to be first thing in the spring and now it's not going to be till midsummer.
He said he was going to come and take care of it.
Okay.
Anybody else have any questions?
Do you have a cost estimate for what these people that didn't sign the easements is going to cost the taxpayer?
It's a pay item on the estimate. I believe it's, I don't know what the cost is, but it's in our pay estimate. It's per each from the right-of-way to the household. It's a dollar amount set, and then there's a dollar amount from the main line to the right-of-way.
Do you know if it's $1,000?
Wherever the pay request, I might have a pay request here. Everybody actually has from the main to the right of way, so that's already established. $1,800.
The taps have already been done?
Yes. Everybody gets a tap. Everybody gets to the Y pole. It's $1,800 from the Y pole up to the house.
Okay. Crushing, drain, the everything.
Yeah.
So each property would be $1,800.
That's what our pay is.
However many there is.
Okay, are there any other questions?
First, I don't like how they filled my ditch in the front of the house.
Okay.
This is Mr. Barr.
What address?
Down by the firehouse.
South of Hodge.
Which is fine the way they did it, but I do want a ditch because all the water is coming right off the road now.
Okay.
Into the yard.
Are you the last house on the... Okay. Yeah.
And when are you going to come around and let us know the depth we're going to be hooked up? Because I'm going to have the house replumbed.
We need to speak with you with the engineer. There's an issue with actually servicing yours, and we might actually, we were able to service another house that needed a grinder, and we might be able to swap it in your case.
I don't want a grinder.
Okay, then it would just have to be replumbed and... We'd have to get, I don't know the depths, but we can meet with you.
I can't have a grinder.
Okay.
Because my footer tile runs through my septic.
Okay. It's something I'll have to come out and actually, you'll have to show me things and I can actually give you where we can come to.
I have a bathroom in the basement, but it can't be hooked up because this, my footer tile actually runs through the bathroom. It's all interconnected when the house was built. So if you hook the grinder pump up to my house, it's going to be running all the time because the footer tunnel runs.
Okay. Yeah, I'll have to get with you after the meeting here. I'll get your information. We can meet and take a look at everything.
I don't know if you can answer it or not, but can you give us an estimate of how long these pumps will last approximately? I know we can maybe ballpark it, get it in ballpark, and what the cost is so we will know what our assessment fee is when down the road.
I can't really give you a time frame. That's not something we don't maintenance any. We just build it, it's up, and then cost-wise, I would have to look and see actually what we're buying it from. HearthTech, it's, we buy a package deal. Everything's coming, like the wet well, it's a one big, large package. So I don't know what individual parts. So I can't really answer, I guess, any of your questions there.
Okay, maybe sometime if you get time, if you could just look in. It doesn't have to be there tomorrow, but ballpark it, so...
I would think Chris would have a pretty good handle on it.
That would be more Chris's.
Yeah, I think he's supposed to be here. He got caught up in traffic, so he might be here at the end, and that's a good question to ask him.
Yeah, he's the one that set up. Okay, are there any more questions?
I'm Brian Kirby.
Thank you, Brian.
Is there any plan to meet with individual homeowners and let us know where you're going to tie in, or do we need to contact you to ask you to come out and talk to us about that so we know how you're tying into our house, like more specifics?
I mean, I'm open at any time. If you guys want to call me, my foreman or myself, we can come and meet with you. But normally, how the plans read, the pipe's coming out of your house and going through your septic tank. Mm-hmm. We're supposed to go within 3 foot of your house. So wherever it exits your house, we will actually make a connection right there. So it's going to be, if you know where that is, that helps us. We're kind of looking. It's not as what the plans are showing.
Okay, so
a lot of people have told us, hey, it's over here, not in the back. So as much information as you can give us.
It would be a benefit if we did contact you to come out and specifically talk to you about our house and some of the other issues, like the gentleman here was talking about with some of the way the water is now acting versus the way it was before. And where we could help you and you could help us as we put stuff back together kind of thing?
Absolutely.
Okay. Do you have contact information?
Yep. I have business cards. I'll leave on the table. And
Jason, you guys can put a spur down there at the bottom of the hill to pick up the three houses on the south side.
I'm talking about down here. Chris was talking with the EPA on it. He has to get approval. I'm not sure where he's at with it right now. So at this time, we're not planning on, and it's not in our schedule to put sewer up that right now.
Okay, is there any more questions?
So it's all 3D grinder pumps.
I think we can service one. Okay. It's just going to be like 15 foot deep lateral.
Okay, are there any other questions? Okay, let's move on. We have the 200-year celebration. And
we're still on old business, but
yes.
I've got, I looked at the rules and regulations, and I don't know who would like to have this, but here's an easement for my property on the corner for a sewer tap when they get around to doing these.
Where is that at?
The corner building.
Does that already have sewer there?
No.
Is there water?
No.
Is it a resident?
No, that's not what the ordinance says. If you read your ordinance, you'll
That's enough.
Section A, number
okay,
five.
That's enough.
Rules and regulations. I believe the solicitor looked at it.
He's looking at it. We'll get back to you on that.
It's not in compliance. No, I'm talking about the easement. It's not, I haven't looked at anything else on the easement side.
Well, why would that be?
It doesn't have certain information on it.
It's the exact
have.
Same.
It doesn't have certain information it's supposed to have, Fred.
It's the exact same easement.
I'm saying it doesn't you, have. It doesn't have I'm, certain information
Fred.
Required
I'm
by.
Draining an easement to the village.
Okay.
I don't know if it's been filed. No, that's right. Will everybody else have to get...
I'm just telling you, this won't meet recorder standards.
Okay.
So that's what I'm trying to say.
Okay.
Whether it may be for the correct number or whatever, it won't meet recorder's standards okay. to be recorded.
So I'm saying I gave an easement to the village. And that's what the rules ask for.
Okay. If the recorder isn't going to accept it, then it doesn't really do any good.
Mr. Hunter is going to make up easements for everybody else that...
But that's not one that...
Is this a...
They're not making
Is this a lot we already did?
No.
This is his...
This is section.
You changed
five. Yes.
What's that?
That was a five.
The lot number was a five?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Now it's a six.
It says 111.
Yeah, that's a different lot number. This number right here, the parcel number.
Well, no, what's the lot number up here supposed to be?
111.
Okay. We didn't do one for 111?
No.
All right.
So there's no water or sewer there now? It's
no.
a garage?
It's a building.
Okay. Is there a well there where you can get water?
I can get water.
Okay, we'll be looking into that. Now, can we continue to old business? And
we've got some other old business about the records.
You already
commission.
Had your minute.
Oh,
I gave you 2 minutes. Yes.
Okay. That says where?
I just told you that.
Okay.
I started
he
that at the
here for any of that.
Yeah.
He came in late.
He was standing in there. Okay. Now, let's go with the 200-year celebration. Becca and Don are here, and they wanted to help with our 200-year anniversary. And they are doing a... I'll let you explain.
We are going to do a festival. We didn't do one last year, but we did one
the year before that.
That church, outside the church, actually is a fundraiser for a group called Teen Challenge, which is for substance abuse. And we plan on doing it, I believe, the 25th of June. And we plan on having some bands. We're going to have free food. At one time, we had games for the kids. So we just...
Did Julie get a holy year yet?
No.
Well, we just thought if you're, you know, doing your 200 celebration, maybe somehow we could incorporate it all
right.
together.
And there is a lot of substance abuse in our community.
Yeah. And, you know, even if it's not for that, we'll
right.
have a lot of good entertainment.
Right.
And when we did it last time, we had, I think, three different groups come. So the only difference is we plan on having the music outside this time instead of inside. So we just thought, well, we could help you guys out and
tie the two together
right.
somehow. Thank you. Be fun.
It's a good idea. Get more
so we can make, we, you guys can make a committee with your church.
Mm-hmm. We have one.
And okay, mm-hmm. then we can make a committee with the village, and then we can.
Yeah. When you at least designate one member from each group to meet instead of all of us having to get together and meet. All right, we all got to be, Monday at 8. You know, maybe just the
Yeah, let us know how you want to do it. And,
okay.
All right. Since you're helping us, we'll go.
Do you guys have any idea, or do you have any plans as of or not, or just still talking?
We were still talking.
Okay.
I had talked to Perrysville.
Any input is appreciated.
Okay.
Yeah. I had talked to Perrysville, and they said that man with the amusement rides, you have to go with the 3-year contract.
Yeah, I figured it's probably kind of late.
Yeah, and at this time, we're not sure that we want to, that's a continuous thing that we want to do.
Maybe keep it lower.
Right. Right.
I know we had like a dunking tank and a bouncy thing and somebody that was painting faces and just, you know, small things.
Have a parade, that would be a great thing.
Yes, everyone had one. Parade. What year was that?
The centennial.
I remember Davey riding his tricycle down
remember
the road
that?
That one.
It was the centennial.
You mean the one that had the jail in front of Mifflin Inn?
Yeah.
Anybody that didn't have facial hair got arrested? I don't remember that.
That's cool.
Yeah.
No.
Had to pay to get out.
Yeah, see? Make some money for the village.
Well, now we've got the jail built, so you can use it.
Yeah. There you go with the facial hair. That's a great idea.
To the music while they're in jail.
Yeah.
Collecting money. Please help me get out.
She wants to there's another person that's came in.
With the gray t-shirt come in.
Sir, can we have you sign?
He's been here.
He's been in?
What's your name? I can write it.
Okay, so what day would you like to get together as have a committee meeting for the, because June is coming there.
Real quick.
Yeah.
If it's in the evening, any day works for me, really.
Mondays mostly is my day off.
Monday's fine.
Okay.
Mondays works.
Okay.
Is that good for you? Guys? Monday's good for you?
Well, I guess Monday's good. I can
not
switch
Monday,
out. I'll get it. I'll do it. Just whatever.
That's your council meeting this Monday?
We could do it like a week from Monday.
Monday.
Yeah, okay.
It's coming.
What time?
Is that the 21st?
It's the 21st.
March 21st.
What time?
That. What time is that like?
6, 7 o'clock, give everybody a chance to go home from work.
Okay, let's do 6. That way it
Does
don't
that
take
three days, 6 p.m. on Monday?
Yeah, that's fine.
It don't, won't take the whole night then.
Yes.
Here?
That would be
church.
Fine.
Do we have to make a public notice? There's a big stink about having meetings here.
We'll do it at the church.
We can just do it at the church.
Okay.
All right.
Cool. Okay. Does anyone else have any other old business?
Did we get a date locked in for spring cleanup?
Yep. May 7th. Mom's going to do it.
May 7th?
Did they send you papers yet, Amy? Okay, I'll contact them.
Thanks,
yeah. Mom's is good. They came back on board with this and they said they'd take
it. Is that
this.
Saturday?
Yeah.
Do you have any other old business?
Yeah, I do. Matter of fact, if
what
I could
is
talk.
It?
About the resolution commission, or
we haven't got to that yet.
Oh, all right. At the last meeting, Pam said that if you had two separate buildings on two separate lots, there would be two separate assessments. Why is Councilman Zahner not getting two assessments?
I was referring to two residents, Freddie. Two residents that people live in.
Really?
Yes.
That's not what you said.
Well, you can read it any way you want.
Okay, this is not personal. This is business.
I was just asking.
Okay.
I would like to know these things. Because if it works for one, it's going to work for all.
That's right. That's right. It's going to stay fair. Any other old business?
Mr. Zahner's alley is a named alley. We had a ordinance number 2 of 2010 named that alley.
there's a, you needed to talk to Pam Neely, because that's going to all go through her, the paperwork that we got to get funding for the survey. So that, I guess, that she goes through, that's kind of a up in the air moot point. Okay. We need an ordinance approving the adoption and enacting the American Legal Publishing Ohio Basic Code 2016 as a code of ordinances for the municipality of the village of Mifflin, Ohio, and declaring an emergency.
That would be 01-2016.
Yeah.
Three. Because we have the appropriations as one and two.
I need a motion to suspend the rules.
So moved.
Second?
I'll second.
Roll call vote.
Lori?
Yes.
Jesse?
Yes.
Dan?
I'm staying.
Deb?
That concerns me.
No.
It's the law. It's the book of the laws. It's the book of the ordinances.
Yes.
It's the Ohio.
Okay, I thought it was personally added.
No.
I vote yeah then.
Deb?
Yes.
George?
Yes.
Pam?
Yes.
Okay. A motion to approve?
A motion.
Second. Okay, roll call vote.
Lori?
Yes.
Jesse?
Yes.
Dan?
Yes.
Deb?
Yes.
George?
Yes.
Pam?
Yes.
Okay. We have an ordinance amending the sewer rates, fees, and charges for sewer services in the village of Mifflin, Ashland County, Ohio. Okay.
I thought I would get a conference call if it had anything like that to vote on.
Right.
And I want to make sure that this is legally done, that there's no ethics going on with that, even getting it to the ordinance.
Council speaks through its ordinances. Even if you vote on something to move forward with an ordinance.
Okay.
Nothing gets passed until you approve the ordinance.
Okay.
So
even though
until this ordinance is passed, nothing's been done. You can vote all you want to, but you speak through your ordinances and resolutions.
Okay. So leading up to the ordinance, everything is legal. All right. Okay.
Yep.
You're absolutely positive.
Can I ask a question?
99.99% sure.
Okay.
How's that?
That'll work.
Okay.
Could I ask a question?
What's your question?
Why is there a change in the time frame that it has to be done now if the sewer is not going to be done until June, July, August, maybe longer?
Just the $500. That's all I think changed.
Well, there's some minor other changes, but
it was gone.
There's nothing about it. There's no time frame change.
It still takes effect in 2017.
The tap fee does, yeah.
Yeah.
All right.
So everybody that's getting the sewer has to pay the tap fee,
No, Pam Ewing got
so
the
grant. So why was there a gap to begin with?
Grants for that for us so that everybody was free.
Let's be clear. You will not, if you hook up before January 1, 2017, there is no tap fee. However, there is a permit fee that everybody has to pay so that the village can have it inspected properly. And that is $250 that everybody will have to pay which is an inspection slash permit fee. Everybody is going to tap into the sewer, regardless of whether you're doing it now or after 2017, that $250 fee still gets paid.
Who's doing the inspection? That's my question.
We will have to find somebody to do this.
Ash and Kemley said they would do it for a fee.
So,
what are they inspecting?
Make sure it's
connection.
What are we doing?
I don't know what you're doing.
We're doing the connection.
Are you checking to make sure all the basement drains are not running?
That's not part of the... So you're getting a home inspection,
right.
Not a inspection
that's
of the extra
thing. Right. Make sure
that everybody has to pay a home inspection of $250.
That makes more sense. So we're actually making a connection, but we don't look inside anybody's home.
Make sure there's
so then they'll inspect the home and see if there's any issues.
They'll come to where your drain is. They'll come to where your drain is.
Outside.
Yes, 3 feet from your house. No. Well, the inspection?
What's the inspection for? While we're being clear, what are these inspecting about?
The inspection... to be paid, a time permit is issued for installation of any service line for connection to the system. Let's see. They're going to inspect everything, it looks like.
So it's a full home inspection, not just a sewer
inspection.
I'm
not going to say it's a full home inspection.
So what is it?
Can I speak? Yes. As a resident of Hayesville, and I may get this wrong exactly, but when we had our sewer system put in, we had to have all ours inspected. And this is where I may get it wrong, but I believe it was Dan Beasley that did the inspections.
That's what I'm saying. I think...
Because he's our...
I didn't go through the whole regulations, but the regulation with regard to the fees... says there has to be an inspection, whether you're hooking it up or not. Somebody's going to do an inspection to make sure it's done properly.
But now, what do they inspect?
I don't know,
but I know Bob was in everybody's basement in Hayesville, so
probably
they went down.
So it's just basically the basement.
I think they inspect the drain goes out to the sewer.
What they were actually inspecting.
Where the drain goes out to the sewer.
See if the basement's clean.
That turns out.
It says all sewers shall be inspected and approved by the village after installation, but before covering with backfill upon inspection and after inspector has satisfied himself that the installation has been made according to the requirements of this ordinance and that all possible sources of stormwater have been eliminated from the sewer, he shall make a sketch of the installation on the form retained by the village at the time the permit was issued, and if such installation complies. The village thereafter. So basically, they're going to inspect the installation point and make sure there's no storm sewer or anything else connected to it.
They have to do it before
they want
to
separate.
They have to do it before they back.
Have running black water, but
right. They don't want that going to the system because it's overburdened everything.
That's what. So that just sounds like they're going to check the outside where
probably
it's tapped in,
like your footer drains.
Well,
that
see, I would be above that,
right.
So we need to get a hold of them.
Now, when they crush my septic tank,
get it set up.
So you got to find somebody to do the inspection.
So my tile will still run.
There's going to be several issues where we actually have to lay the pipe through.
What's that?
I'll do each one for 2 6.
We're finding that as we're talking to homeowners.
I'm sure you will.
I think it might be a conflict of interest there.
Probably.
Freddie, do you do inspection? That'd be a conflict too.
It's really going to be
right.
A resident. We're going to need as much knowledge as you guys can give us to make it worth just not spending time and get it done as quick as possible.
That's what I was just trying to figure out, what water we were expecting.
Chris, we'd have to wait for Chris because Mr. Parks is the one that is sending in our reports. So he could be able to tell us because he's the one that is ahead of testing the water and everything, doing the testing. When
we
the sewer gets set up, when the sewer gets set up and sending the EPA report.
Oh, yeah, whoever your operator is, they will be doing the testing and monitoring that.
So anybody, whether they signed an easement or they signed the easement, they have the $250 fee?
Yes.
Okay.
I guess that was my question.
Yes.
But does the changing of the date of this ordinance change anything as far as the $500 fee?
Yes. The change in the date of this ordinance, what do you mean by changing the date of the ordinance?
Well, there was an ordinance for the sewer rates.
Which they're amending.
Okay.
Or the proposed is.
So anybody that has an easement now upon passing this one does not have to pay any penalties that were different between the two?
They don't have to pay the $500.
The way it reads is...
But they still have to pay the $250.
Right. Everybody has to pay that.
Before, I believe it said, I don't have the old one.
It was just a line that said there was a $500 fee, and that's about all it said.
Right.
If easement is not provided to the village, an additional $500 fee is required. Now it says, if easement is not provided for existing houses, buildings, or properties used for human occupancy, employment, recreation, and so forth, in which there is now located or may in the future be located a public sewer during the construction phase, meaning before they get done with their construction of it, then an additional $500 fee is required. If you sign the easement before they get done, then there's no $500 fee. Anybody after, if after January 1, if the easement's not provided, there's a $500 fee regardless.
But before this ordinance, it was anybody that didn't sign it before the last deadline.
Correct.
So why was there a deadline then? Why was there a...
EPA.
EPA application.
Tim, you have a question.
So are we going to be in trouble with the EPA if we change that?
No. The EPA application was, as I understand, to get additional funding for the village and anybody that signed an easement. They based their application on the number of easements,
yes,
so that they could get the funding. There's going to be additional funding potentially left over that could pay for anybody that didn't sign the easement.
Now, on that same note, how much did the village incur on sending out?
I don't know.
I mean, is there any way to recoup that money back into the village?
Sending out what?
The notices for the people that did not comply, did not sign the easement.
Or the certified letter.
That would be part of the, should be part of the contingency.
It's part of the, okay. So we don't need to worry about that money? Okay.
Tim, you had a question?
Yeah, do you have a fee schedule, like what after this all gets done, as far as what the fee, monthly fees are going to be, and do you know how much it's going to cost a year to run it?
The monthly fee...
For non-residential or residential?
For his business.
Business.
Or in general, I mean, based on receipts, Tim.
What's that?
It's based on receipts, like a house or... For your business, my business.
This says that there's a flat rate for residential $28.50 and a non-residential
per ERU.
ERU.
And $32.06 for non-residential per ERU.
ERU, I'm
tight. Equivalent residential unit.
That's how many gallons you use a day,
basically.
Based on the
EPA.
So how about business? My business. Yours would probably be based on your CD. Probably one and a half.
Aren't you putting in more seating?
What?
Are you putting in more seating?
Yeah. Might want to wait.
You have the same. Do you have the same amount of seating as you had before? Or are you putting in
how
more?
Many, I
just don't put stools around your bar.
I guess I'm.
Stand up. Until afterwards. And
you have a capacity then.
No, I'm just...
You have a capacity.
I probably do. I don't know what it is. Yeah.
Okay.
All public places have a capacity.
Yeah. Chris would have that. I mean, we got it somewhere.
Yeah.
Yay.
Chris should have it. Thank you, God.
Yep.
You are the man.
He even got his that's not really fire.
I didn't hear what you said. You guys lost me here. So, like, if I had no seats, I wouldn't have to pay anything.
No. Nice try, but no.
You can sit right
in the front row, buddy. Just for
is
you.
Is there a trap door there?
It's you not wish. A safe seat. Yeah. You might be
the only thing
you
could have made it slower is if that rain was freezing.
Don't move.
It's
not a safe seat.
Tim Parks here?
He's right next to you.
Oh, there he is. He's cleaned up, see? Apparently couldn't put down.
We are talking about the sewers, we're thinking of amending the ordinance for the people that didn't sign the easement for them not to pay the $500 fee.
Okay.
And they're worried about everybody not having enough money or how you're going to use that money that's left over, because what's left over you're sending back to the EPA, right?
Well, you'll never get it, so there'll be no sending back. You just simply will never get that money. We have 10% contingency on the project. What's the total project construction cost?
Two something.
We got $200,000+. We haven't had a change order yet, correct? And you got the pay request for this time, so yeah. We're about... what, 60% done with the project?
I would say so.
Okay. And generally, change orders happen when you're doing gravity sewer, when you're doing the collection system. I mean, a lot of times, that's where you run into problems. You could hit a big rock that you wasn't expecting, or someone's house could be completely in a different spot than you thought, or, you know, anything odd could happen. And we're doing the laterals, so the laterals are always questionable. And they've been doing a great job with Tim on working with the folks to get the laterals in without any issues, to cut down on any kind of change orders there, I think. Mm-hmm. So we're 60% of the way through the project, and we still have 260-some thousand in change order. We do have one here that I brought with me today. That's part of the reason I'm late, that in the rain. But we put one together to add a bit of an extension along Main Street on the lower side, to cut down on having the laterals go through that steep hillside that's real deep on a few homes. There's three homes and then a Legion, American Legionary, I think.
We can service them.
So those will be serviced through this new extension.
You mean the Lions Club?
Lions
Club?
Yeah, that.
Yeah. Lions Club, okay. Every town's got a different... I'm working with a town now that's got an American
Here goes
Legion.
Our contingency.
Sometimes they're fraternal order of Eagles, there's ambets. Every town's got a different one, it seems like. So anyway, I just cost us out at about $18,000, although I'm not exactly sure what they have in mind, so I did that for the permit application. But if that's the case, if we run about this 318 feet of 8-inch... and then that one manhole. Mm-hmm. So am I
Which
in the ballpark?
Which we saved a manhole, actually two manholes, and I think it was about 150 foot already. We decided not to take an extra run up due to that. We found a septic system on the opposite side. There was no reason to run the main line 8-inch all the way up. We just ran a longer lateral. So that saved the village here money. We can actually use that in this other spot to make sure that everybody gets service with gravity.
So all in all, the application fee and the work, we probably won't be over $15,000 without adding that line, which would make it a cleaner job overall, because you won't have a shutoff that's real deep, that you won't have to cut the trees down in those folks' yards. And they also found that one of the septics comes out the front, not the back, right, and that sort of thing. So Tim and Jason and everybody's in agreement that'd be a good idea. So I put that together I'd asked them if we needed a permit, to change order permit for that, and the Ohio EPA wanted a change order permit for that. It's only 318 feet of pipe, and you won't even know it's there when they're done. So we could do it without it, but it makes it a lot easier and a nicer job for you in the end, so I think we should go ahead and do that. But we're probably not looking at over 15,000, maybe 20,000. So we'll still be in the 240,000 range when we get to the plant, hopefully. The lift station's basically ready to go. Mm-hmm. He's got a question. I'm ignoring for right now, but I'll get to
okay.
it. So the plant is coming soon. The only issues that we could run into there generally are if the electric was some odd, something odd, or you know, something odd with the building. But I don't. Do you expect any change orders?
As of right now.
So it's a pretty simple plant with a fairly simple building. Can you think of anything that may come up that?
No.
Okay. So. It's very likely we'll have plenty of money to serve all those folks. And then at the point in time that they're done, EPA money has disappeared and the project's completed, then you can start charging that tap fee for the new folks. The main reason that's there is to hire people like Tim to do an inspection on it when you put in a new system, so you know you don't get a rinky-dink lateral to your village system. So that's one big part of it. You know, you'd hire an inspector, your inspector, to go out and look at that new lateral. When this is completely done and it's 10 years from now, someone puts a new home in, they put in a new lateral and tap to your line, you'd have them do all that work likely as size your village is. You wouldn't have someone do that for the village. But you would have to have it inspected, so you'd hire an inspector to look at it and make sure it's done right, the right materials, the right slopes, the right kind of tap, so you don't get a lot of water, groundwater or stormwater into there. So that's why the tap fee is there, really. The other thing was we was hoping everybody signed easement, you know, initially, so we wouldn't get into those kind of problems, but we knew all along that we would have contingency very likely that would cover those, so I don't foresee an issue.
Has everybody signed now?
The ones that I've got the, if there's one that has it, they were out of town.
But, I
yeah, and the ones he has here.
So the point
but
of the,
everybody has agreed to sign.
The point of the funding was by Ohio EPA was to get everybody they could onto a centralized system. So it's actually kind of to let people get on now with no cost would be kind of the whole essence of the project, that we should try to get as many people on as we can so we don't have issues in the future. But now that's up to you guys how you do that. I know that every connection is good for the environment, good for the sanitation of the village, and good for you as a village because you got more users. And if I can't say 100%, none of us can right now, that we'll absolutely have the funds, but it seems like we should have, you know. And you're right in that if we don't use those funds to put those laterals in, the money will disappear.
It doesn't come to us.
It won't come to you, and it will never come to you. You only get it when you do something, and then you pay it out, and then pay them. So if you did need to use it, you might as well, because it's going to disappear in the, you know, larger scheme of things.
How do you, when it comes down to it, and there's not quite enough, how do you figure that out to help everybody?
We'll be out of money, or we'll still have money.
No, I mean, you don't have help. Like, say you've got enough to cover everybody.
Over my wallet, and I said, "Dang, go on!" I thought I had another dollar. That happens to me all the time. Well, that's a good question. I mean, he could work on that with you, and then the council can decide. If you've got $30,000 and you need $50,000, maybe you just divvy it up between them. And then, you know, everybody pays a third of what they would have normally paid.
Right.
Would be the fair way to do it.
Or go so many feet for each house and whatever.
Well, them do the whole thing and then look at what you got in total costs and split the cost up.
Okay.
I try to keep it uniform so you don't... Really, there's not a lot of homes that's a long distance here. They're all about the same. There was one guy on the hillside that was the longest, but he's done. So, I mean, all the rest of them that you have is kind of remaining. are fairly equal, and the effort's about the same. A lot of the effort's getting the equipment on there and doing this, you know, actually getting the line up to it. Not that, you know, if the line's 30 feet to 50 feet long, it's not that much difference in effort.
Okay. But so it'll all end up fair, so.
Okay. I know this sounds socialistic, but. I would try to keep it simple and just make sure that everybody that wants hooked on try to keep their cost affordable.
Okay.
I really do think, though, that, and this was the one snafu here that we kind of thought may happen, and it, you know, it's absolutely not necessary. It's not absolutely necessary, but makes it a nicer job for you. And we knew we had some contingency. It's not a very expensive change. But other than that, we're not really seeing anything. All the collection system's in, right?
Yes, except for the what you have in
and
your
hand there.
And we
got the force main up to the plant from the
we have some
lift
bores
station.
We have to do.
Okay.
But as for the actual main line, we have no change orders for the main line.
Right.
But
that means you hired a good engineer.
From what we didn't install.
So. And I was under pressure. Members, I didn't get any sleep for 3 months. The easiest thing to mess up is an elevation. And then when you do that on gravity sewer, it's a mess. Because if one's flowing uphill, then they're all, it's a real concern. I mean, when you're doing it, you can't set a marble in there and see if it's going to end up at the plant when you're looking at it on paper.
Right.
So you got to envision that, but it's, So, anyway, I told somebody the other day, some attorneys, don't worry, be happy. I think we got plenty of money. There's another thing that Pam Ewing could do for us, whether she would be willing to or not, at this point, is if any of those, let's say we absolutely had no money left, something really odd happened, you still qualify for some other, those folks, if they're LMI eligible, could qualify for CDBG funds of $100,000 for connections of laterals. It's just that we don't normally get into that so late in the project, but I think Tim Leisure would work with you, the CDBG administrator. If you had five of those 12 that were basically, you know, very impoverished, we could get those connected probably with those funds, and Pam Ewing would be the one to do that.
Okay.
I don't suspect that'll have to happen, but we could look at if we were worried about that, we could go ahead and get that process started, but I'm not really that concerned, really. I think we'll have enough. How many do we have left?
Well, I counted 17.
17.
17 easements.
Yeah, budgeted, just say 2,000 each for those. And then decommissioning.
It's all pay item, whatever we have established for it.
Yeah. So let's just say it was 3,000 each.
There's no issue with no change, unless there's something with the plant that comes
50,000.
Up.
It could be under 50,000 for all those. And we got probably 250,000 available, so I don't think so. You might want to get your new homes built on your empty lots real quick. So you can
that's what I'm wondering. You lot of, like my mom's lot, it has water and sewer on it. There's just not a house anymore. Does that get to be put in with a fee, without a fee?
We're avoiding those because it's a gravity collection and we don't want extra taps with caps.
All right.
It's just a good source for IMI. And we really can't, with a straight face, ask for it. Funding for that.
Right.
It's really for the existing customers of the village.
But if the house got put on there before.
Well, no one ever envisioned that. I was kind of jokingly saying
right,
that.
I'm just
saying. It's something we can look at.
Is that possible?
You'd have to bring in a modular or something.
Right. So if I did that.
I'd like Tim to make a call on that.
But if I did that.
But he's a nice guy, so he'd probably say.
Who would you talk to? If I was wanting to go for the modular or just even a single wide on there, I would make sure it covered first. So I guess where would you find that out?
Well, you know, if we got money, we can make it happen. If we don't, then we can't. So it's a gamble.
Right.
But
Well, I'm just thinking.
The council would have to agree to it, basically. Right. So it would be an act of council.
So I guess there needs to be something said right now, you know, before they do all pop up.
Not to interrupt, but this new ordinance says that if it happens while these guys are still here, it's only going to cost $250.
That's for the inspection.
The top fee? Or?
No, this is an inspection fee, I believe.
Right.
There's no tap fee until 2017.
Now, you really wouldn't need an inspector because we've got Tim here. I mean, he's working on the project. If it's EPA funded, we can, you know, you're paying me and I'm hiring him to do that. And we're, you know, we're organizing those inspections. So I don't even
so
think
we don't have to.
We don't need the 250.
Cost the village, though?
No. I mean, he's going to be here doing the work. And if it's during the time frame of the project, there is a termination of that work at 10 months, which we may creep up on. But the extension of that could be done through the change orders of from contingency. But you got a lot of contingency left, so I mean we'll still be here doing that work until the plant's operating.
That's been the original ordinance from day one when we passed the initial.
The 250.
Yeah, that's not a change now. That's been in there.
It's up to you. But I know Tim will be here if you're installing them. And if they let me step back. If Elite's installing them as part of this project, then we're covering the inspections right now. So, you know, you wouldn't have to hire a special inspector or anything like that.
Which inspection are you talking about?
The lateral inspection when you install.
This 250 is for inside inspection that you're talking about in there.
Oh. That's not what we said. Remember, we just read it and it said. Concerned about stormwater and all that stuff. Inspecting it before it's covered.
Basement drains, clear tile.
So why couldn't that 250 be put in the general fund?
It wouldn't go to the general fund. It would go to the sewer fund.
That's what I mean. The fund for the sewer pipe.
That's why I was just suggesting. That's why I was suggesting the mayor that you go ahead and still collect it. That way you've got it there to make repairs in the future if you need to.
Yeah, I thought you meant that. I thought it was a lateral.
Especially if we're getting rid of the 500.
Yes.
So if I put 5 mobile homes in while these guys are still here.
How did I know you'd be the guy that'd be able to do that since you bought 12 acres?
I'm a deacon with Providence Church. We're currently at the Lions Club, and our plan would be to put a church in up there west of Ohio Street. And I didn't know if this was a good time to bring that up, if there's any ability to put a tap that direction that we would be able to tie into closer, or if that's a dead end that you don't want to have in there now. We're probably looking 2 to 3 years from now, so it's not like it's going to be tomorrow. And we're not probably going to put a modular unit there to worship in at this point.
The gravity lines will be there, so when you build your church, all you'll need to do is put your lateral into the gravity line. And it will be very cheap compared to putting an on-lot system on, you know. And you could do that cheaper than we're doing it because they're working at state prevailing wage. And you'll be doing it maybe with some volunteer labor or, you know, some local workers. So it probably cut our cost in half of what that is. But we really can't extend any laterals into vacant lots with this funding. But it will be there to serve you when it comes time, you know. And a tap, you know, Fred's probably done. He's calling me. They're done all the time. So Tim probably's done too. You know, this project helps you tremendously because you'll have that service available when it comes to
right. That was part of our
reason.
That was my original question I never got to ask.
I forgot about that.
I said that.
I wasn't going to let you.
You didn't raise your hand.
I did.
Yeah, he did. I pointed at him a couple times.
I was in midstream. I forget what I'm talking
about. If I'm understanding this right, instead of your line item for the laterals being per lineal foot, it's each?
For each property, and what we quoted or estimated this project, what we saw on the plans.
Okay,
so we do differ from that, we will have a cost for extra material and for going around.
Where I was going with this is, if it was an each or a lineal foot, those three that you're running that extra line for, you're actually saving money on, because now you're only half the distance.
Well,
yes,
I'm kind of.
I know where the septic is at the Lions Club. I know where it is at the other house. And yeah. I know where it is at the third house.
Kind of, but we can't really.
I see what you're saying. The lateral is shorter.
It's shorter, and yeah. It's not 25 foot deep.
I got you.
It's not really easy to ascertain the exact cost savings, but I can tell you that they already saved us 150 feet of line and two manholes. So this is almost paid for from the savings. So, I mean, that's kind of, you know, splitting hairs on that because the...
Well, no, you're talking about how much is left of the contingency. I'm saying you're actually saving a little. It's less than what it's
saving.
I think it's less than what he's quoting right now because we saved that other material and everything's already. We're not just going to say, hey, we're going to quote this and it's going to be whatever number. It's
so
what
you're
our
the
pay
kind
items
of guy
are.
I needed when I was building my house because I always got.
I'm a retired state inspector.
Well, here's the problem we got into this project. I didn't know exactly where the laterals were going to go. And so I had to guess. And then when I guessed, then everybody wanted to know how much length. And I said, wait a minute. If we do that, then it's going to be a mess because they're all going to change, which they all basically have changed. And so I basically begged all these bidders to trust me and just put in a lump sum for each one. And we work with them as we went to try to make it the, you know, most cost-effective way to do that. And that they had to work with each homeowner, which I think they had went to every home to work with them on where it was going to go. So we just got lucky that they were honest and have done a good job. And
well, I have no complaints.
We was trying to be flexible, yeah. So that's why we didn't do the linear foot. Everything else was basically, you know, to the T on the feet and whatnot.
But I still have a question.
So if I have five. If you had that would be an act of council probably to decide if they would extend that to the folks. I can't say that for certain, but I don't see why there wouldn't be any ability to if we've got money left. Yeah. You know? Because I think that if you sign an easement and they're still here and EPA really wants everybody they can to connect to this,
right.
Nobody really likes this, you know, less users. They want more users. So it's up to the council, though, you know.
Let's continue with.
There was a question, Chris, while you're here, about the cost per month per house.
Business. Yeah.
The way the ordinance reads, it's $28.50 per month if it's a residence, or $32.06 per month if it's a business. That's just a flat rate, right?
Yeah.
Get out.
You don't have water meters. You don't have public water, so it's impossible basically to get a usage bill for this project.
They probably all just go outside and go around the corner anyway, don't they?
Yeah, it's country.
The only way to do it is a flat roof.
Who goes outside?
The other thing you get into in areas where there's basically a complete rural area around it is someone will always say, well, I'm not paying that by the gallon because I got horses, or I'm watering my lawn with 80% of my water, so I'm not paying that much sewer. So really, we worked on this probably a year ago, I suppose. The only way to do a community like this, I don't care what community it is, even if they got water meters, is to do a flat rate because of those issues. And then, you know, realistically, folks don't really abuse water like folks think they would.
Right.
Like, you don't go home and say, well, my sewage is $28. I'm just going to turn on the faucet.
Right.
I mean, really, people right. don't do that. Right. So you're going to take the same shower as you would have.
Your water pump is running in your, you know.
So you might, if you had public water and was paying per gallon, use less to sprinkle your garden. But
right.
that's not affecting your sewage. So be honest, that's not really an issue. The difference in commercial cost was, most communities have a little higher rate for commercial. So I did some research. We looked at other communities in the area. which is what EPA likes to see you do to kind of get it. I think it was one and one quarter the rate
right.
for businesses. And then most folks, when they go out of town, if you did extend out of town in the future, you guys want to be here till midnight?
No.
We could go on. But most people charge rate and a half outside the community. So you stepped forward and all you went ahead and went through all this hassle and hardship and, you know, through the disaster of building it with your streets and all, and then the folks up the road want attached. Well, the way you do that is to gain back some of that, that, you know, hardship that you had and all that initial capital cost, which you, as an unusual situation, have no capital cost. But generally, you've been paying back debt for years when they want to hook on. So you generally charge them 1.5 rate. And it's not because you're being mean. It's just that you're trying to get money back in your fund that you spent on debt. But that's up to you when it comes to it. But you could bring some folks in outside the village in the future. You just need an intergovernmental agreement from the county. But that's why the rate was a little higher on commercial. And it's not necessarily the flow. It's the waste strength generally is higher from a commercial facility. So you're treating waste strength. Waste strength is directly related to how much electric you use and how much pumping and all, you know, the pumping and aeration. So that's actually a pretty minor increase for a commercial facility.
And that's all based on EPA estimates and...
Yeah, well, there's examples of other communities, and they suggest when you're doing your billing rate to follow the examples of other communities around. So you could be, you could go to, say, Mansfield even, and they would have a higher rate for industrial users. One of the big things you don't do in an industrial facility is you don't take showers. So your waste is really weak when you're taking a shower. So if you're just running the toilet all day, like an Amish window factory, your waste strength is 4 times what a normal home is. So it does affect it a bit, and that helps compensate for that.
So, like, commercial, what do you expect on the bill to be, a monthly bill?
I think they have
3206
a month. Per month.
Times.
Yeah, times your equivalent of a home. So the amount of waste flow that you produce would be determined by general design flows for your kind of facility and then rated to the amount that a home produces. So when you figure out what a home normally produces by looking at design flows, and I think for this community it's 264 gallons a day. So then if you've got, let's say you've got a church with 500 pews or 500 seats and there's no food service, so that would be 3 gallons per seat per day is the design flows. So you calculate that, and then you divide that by 264, and that gives you your equivalent number of homes at that church.
Yeah, Tim, it says right.
And then it comes up according to the sale. Yeah,
well, but the 3250 is if you've got 5 equivalent residences.
But I don't know the formula. That's what I'm trying to say.
You can multiply that by 5.
It says right in the rules and regulations.
So it could be, you know, a little bit higher than 3250.
So now a church is considered a business also?
It will tell you exactly what it costs.
Anything that's not a home.
Okay. All right.
Is that
nobody's bothered to read them?
I don't know. Like, okay, I own the drive-thru in a small bar. So what will my bill be a month?
Look, you've got a calculator for every facility. I don't have it memorized.
Yeah.
It's, I don't have it memorized.
It's not calculated yet. But have you been getting a pre-billing?
Yeah. The $45.
I guess. I don't know.
Yeah.
Probably.
They're in the bag, Deb. Or it's in the bar. It's $45. How much is it?
Rate fee. It's I think it's saying $45. Yeah. Maybe. I don't know.
Everybody needs
no,
the same.
Nothing.
On the assessment.
Tavern, very little food service. 18 cents per seat.
That's
it. On top of the 3206, right?
No.
No?
It's a minimum, I think, Chris. The minimum is the minimum.
Well, I thought the user charge, I thought Pam had already calculated for that on the salary. We'll get through those numbers. If you haven't been getting charged that, because we'll have to calculate it.
I'm just getting charged.
No, they're just getting a flat, everybody is getting a flat $15 a month assessment
okay.
right now.
Wonder when, Pam's not here, but wonder when you're going to go to your full rate. The Ohio EPA recommends 6 months prior to initiation of operation. So you kind of project happens. Out and say when you're going to have a plant run, and they can tell you. And then you start that 6 months prior to that.
That's not what it says. No, it says
that
the assessment drops off.
When $15 drops off, once you flip the switch.
All right,
I'm also a township trustee, and I'm going to say something that's going to come out wrong, but this project is how much money? $3 million plus? Yeah. Okay, you're building a plant on township land that you don't own yet. Correct. We made an agreement, a written agreement, over a year ago.
No, that's not true.
Yes, it is true.
There was a road that the village owned. It was a platted roadway.
I don't care what you think.
It's not been done yet.
It's township land.
It was never finished previously.
The survey was not completed yet to transfer that land to the village.
No, we laid the plant out on the 50-foot road width of Main Street, the old platted Main Street. That is the village property. Then the new Main Street cuts lot 1, 2, and 3 of the village and went past your garage, okay? And you ended up with the three triangular parcels generated. One was triangular, the other two were polygonal in shape from lots 1, 2, and 3. We don't have a whiteboard. But the village still owned that platted Main Street. And we have proof of that. I mean, it's a platted street of the village. It's the village property, village street. So it was not a...
That track that was sitting on township ground right now.
Well, Fred was working with you guys to get a hold of those three parcel pieces.
Yeah, we have no problem with it. But what I'm saying is, you have a $3 million project, and you're... building a plant on land that you don't even own is what I don't understand.
Let me get this.
And I just want to get a question on how much it's going to cost me, and you guys can't tell me that even?
Yeah, we can, but we got to have some time to calculate it.
We can get back to you, Jim.
I can tell you right now.
There's no reason to get cynical about this.
No, I'm not getting cynical. Okay. I mean, we are actually... have been very cooperative as a township.
Yeah.
You know, I'm just saying it. I'm just saying that I don't understand.
We got a lot of folks working on the user charge. I haven't personally been involved, so when we will figure that out and we'll come to the next meeting, we'll have that for you. The property, if it is not village property and the plant's been built on the wrong spot, you did the site title opinion, right?
I pointed out earlier that we needed to get that survey done several months ago, and it's not been done yet.
It's done now. It's at the plant map office,
and it should be here within a week.
But we never used any of that township parcels of the split portions of lots 1, 2, and 3 of the village. We absolutely did not use those. The only reason that there was encroached was that... Once we got started, Fred had worked out a deal with the township, and that deal was they could start working on those areas because they were going to transfer that property.
No, there was no deal like that.
Okay, well...
No.
Okay. No. You're saying yes, he's saying no.
No, there was not.
I mean, they can get off of those partial lots. I mean, there's room to work there. It'd be tighter for them, but...
It's not that. It's just the idea. What I'm saying is...
He just wants an answer.
I can't understand how if I'd start working on your land without an approval or anything, I think you'd probably be kind of upset. I'm representing a township here,
right?
As far as that,
yeah.
And I think somebody dropped the ball here, and I just want to know. And Vicky's—they're trying to get it worked out, but. You know, I just come up to ask a simple question. Well, I wasn't going to bring that up, and then
it's a trespass if they step on your property.
The only thing was the survey.
Can you give me his?
We had a change in mayor.
Didn't you say March. It was 38 something? Did you just throw out that number?
Yeah. 3206.
So that's per what it is, or what?
Oh, it's somebody's
per seat.
Yeah.
Plus Chris, he owns the end zone.
Basically, how many RCs he had.
So
Here's what I would suggest. We're not going to be able to figure it out here as a group.
You don't have to figure it out. No, I just want to know it so I can start budgeting.
What I would suggest is in your next billing, we'll send out a flyer without saying what your future bill will be.
Awesome.
One quick question. Do you know how much it's going to cost to operate this per year in the future?
Somewhere here there's a preliminary engineering report about that thick that spells all that out.
Right, so, in there.
I can't recite the numbers off my head, but you're happy to look at it. It's behind you there in the room somewhere.
In a big notebook over there.
So, is the town going to be able to afford to operate it with the money? That's what...
If they couldn't, then EPA wouldn't have funded it. I mean, we had to prove that this is an affordable, long-term solution for the community before they were granted the money. And that monthly user charge was an affordable charge. You're looking at me confused. You don't walk in and say, I want $3 million. It takes you about a year of proof of a lot of information, a lot of background work, and then you prove to them that there's need, that it's affordable, that the customers can afford it. It can be maintained. Someone like Tim can operate it. A certified operator can handle the plant. So there's a lot to it. But in the end, the result is that your bill won't be sky high. You will be able to afford it. It will properly treat the sewage. And we can get everybody in the village on it. So we've done a lot of, we've been working on this over 2 years probably. There's been a lot of upfront work to make sure that is the case. The numbers are there, but I can't recite them off the top of my head.
The survey was done on the 6th of February. So it was going through the plant map office. Then it has to be approved, and then we can do the closing.
It is a hard question, but the answer is that USDA has what's called Appendix 7, what they consider soft goods in a plant, and they have a replacement schedule that's required for replacement charge calculations. So it really doesn't matter how long the pump will last. That limits the length of time that we have to calculate a pump replacement. But the pumps will last longer than the time that USDA has actually suggested that the pumps have to be replaced.
Okay.
The fact of the matter is that USDA has been the one to take the brunt of people not being able to afford to run their sewage plants, because they funded a lot of projects like this back in the 70s and 80s, and now they're not bringing in what they should to make payments and whatnot. So they made it very stringent on replacement, specifically replacement fees. So when you're looking at pumps, if the pump would last 10 years, they're going to make you say that you got to replace it at 5 on their list. So realistically, everything will last longer than we've calculated a replacement need. Just because of that fact, everybody uses that USDA guideline for replacement.
Which makes sense. Can you ballpark what one of them pumps cost?
I can't because I did not. I've got those numbers in that preliminary engineering report. But if I tell you $400, you're looking at it, it'll say 5.
Yeah.
But it's in the hundreds of dollars range, You're not looking at thousands, you're looking at $300, $400, $500. They're small pumps and injectors and pumps. Tim would probably know.
The main pump station, that's going to be more expensive.
Yeah.
Because they bigger pumps.
Okay.
See,
that's
going to
be a whole lot more.
Okay, let's move on. Tim, we will get back to you about the closing and about your monthly rate will be.
I would suggest that we'll get that calculated and put it as a part of the show them on their next bill.
Don't hold me to it.
No, I won't.
Future bill will be. And that way everybody would know then.
I'd say 15.
Does that sound like a good idea?
It'll be sent out April 1st.
Repairs in between that.
Okay.
You like that, Vicki?
I like that. Okay, let's continue.
Well, I mean, I don't want to tell you it's going to be $50 and then 60 or 30.
I've got a gavel.
Okay. Is there anybody else with anything they'd like to say? Okay, let's move on to this ordinance. Okay, we need an ordinance for amending the sewer rates, fees, charges for sewer service in the village of Mifflin, Ashland, Ohio.
We need a motion to suspend the rules.
We need a...
Who all was able to do that?
It's everybody but Dan.
No.
Is that one I'm not allowed to vote on?
Oh, yeah, Pam. I'm sorry. I mean, I knew that.
You really stick to ethics. They're very, very important.
Dan and Pam can't vote.
Can we get a roll call?
Lori?
Yes.
Jesse?
Yes.
Deb?
Yes.
Dan?
I got to abstain from this, right?
Right.
George?
Yes.
Pam?
Abstain.
Can we get a motion to approve?
I'll make a motion.
Second?
I'll second.
Roll call vote.
Lori?
Yes.
Jesse?
Yes.
Deb?
Yes.
Dan?
Abstain.
George?
Yeah.
Pam?
Abstain.
Now
we're
doing the ordinance.
Are we done with those?
Okay. Okay, well, does anyone have any other new business since I rushed Mr. Hawk through because he had another appointment to go to?
I got one point to bring up. It's about roof. Okay. They're going to put a sewer system down there where he hasn't got any water and he doesn't have any electricity. Okay. How does it work?
You're looking at me. I don't know.
You're the engineer.
What property are you talking about?
Lot 88.
I'm in the...
Okay. Ain't lot 87. She's down lot 87.
The is that the trailer?
Yeah.
They're right down in the valley over there.
But
okay.
Can you look that one up? I think I don't remember that one being one that we were connecting, but that would be one that would need it, right?
Well, you, what kind of pump works without water?
Dan.
The man doesn't have any electricity. He doesn't have any water. He carries his water down
to
EPA. That was what comes
it's
from
right
EPA.
In there. Everybody has to hook up.
EPA saying that.
It's not the council, it's EPA.
They wanted that house served in the health department. They were working with the health department on that. They considered it unsanitary conditions. If we didn't serve him, then even though he doesn't have water, then it would kind of be the village's fault. So to resolve any of those kind of legal issues with, you know, making the guy live in unsanitary conditions.
He's on.
Everybody's trying to be nice. Well,
He put it there
when he does get water, right. He'll hook into it, you know.
Oh, he doesn't have to pay for it until he hooks into it then.
I don't believe that's the case. I believe you send him a bill. That's my understanding. I think that's up to the village, but...
Well, the village is then going to end up owning a property that they're going to have to clean up.
You can assess his property taxes. You know, that's the only route.
So, in other words, you're going to drive a man out of Mifflin.
Well, it's up to the council how they deal with that. I mean, you can let him go in arrears for probably years, right? I mean, it's a legal question, but I don't know what you would decide. I know that everyone here is paying, and he should pay, and EPA wanted him to connect. And if he signed an easement, was he one of the ones that...
No, he didn't.
Yeah, he signed an easement.
Did he?
I think he did, yeah, okay. Actually.
then he's got a, you know, right to connection, and he's part of the community. You need to welcome him as a connection. So other than that, I don't have any explanation for you. Shut that off. I can't resolve all the world's problems, but I can tell you that you have to be fair. And if you're fair, then you generally resolve all the issues that are created. You know, legal issues, public issues, societal issues. So if we're just trying to be fair, the fair thing to do there is to get him something down there that he can pump his sewage up to the road and get it into the collection system. At that point in time, then it'll be running to the treatment plant, you know. I don't know what he's doing there without water or sewer, and I wouldn't want to live that way, but I can envision
how you want to live and how I want to live might be right. Two different things, you know. He's never had water down there.
Okay. Are there any other new business?
I do have a question. I don't know if it's a village question or a legal question. But that, I don't know how long ago, we had that alley beside my mom's house. There's a tree growing in the middle of it. Is that an alley? Is that village property or is that my mom's property?
At this moment, I'll have to check into that because I don't know.
So if somebody gets hurt going through there, who's responsible?
That's why the village is getting a survey, hopefully, to figure out where all these boundaries are on all these properties and where the alleys are.
Well, there's so supposedly an alley there, but there's a grown tree in the middle of the so-called alley.
There's supposedly alleys running right through the middle of buildings, too.
Right.
So. Right.
So after the survey's done, we know?
Yep. It's definitely an unmaintained alley, then.
Oh, my mom and dad's been maintaining it for years. They've been mowing that alley.
Oh. Well, the village is taking care of it.
Right.
Okay, any other new business? So we're going to meet the Monday after next at the church.
Is this a council committee or is this a this meeting for Monday? Is that a council committee or is it just a private group?
It's a committee for anybody that wants to be in.
But it's not a council delegated committee.
No.
And it doesn't have to be. It's for the
2000. It's for the 200-year celebration.
I'm just making sure that it, you don't have to advertise as a special meeting.
And we're not having it here either.
Right. Okay, do we have a...
At the church, how are we going to have margaritas?
I got a question about...
What's that? How are we going to have margaritas at the church?
You and him.
We'll step outside over the balcony.
I got a question about quads in the village. Is the chief going to start stating people?
What's that?
As far as the sheriff said, yes.
Lawnmowers, everything is not...
You have to look in the Ohio Revised Code.
Yeah.
I think we got to get that posted up, though, so that, or at least have them...
Isn't that just the law?
It shouldn't have to.
It is against the law.
But we've, but it's gone on so long in the village.
Unlicensed vehicles. Isn't that against the law?
Depends and they knew it was illegal. They just did it because they're not...
Depends on how they're marked and what you're using them for and if they're licensed.
There was a side-by-side at the church last night.
No, that's up to the sheriff.
I don't know how I read
it. What is it?
It's a village.
It's up to the sheriff. If the sheriff approves of it, then...
We'll just worry about ours. I'm not worried about everybody else's. Yeah.
Where does it say the sheriff...
What the... We were told.
If you look under the basic code, it specifically outlines who can operate on the street or who can't. You can cross the street, you can ride along the street. You can't ride on the street.
You can cross it or ride along it.
Right.
Oh. Okay.
That's
75.02, chapter 75 covers all that.
You're riding along the street, but you're in somebody else's yard.
How much
work?
The sheriff said that him and the highway patrol were pulled down here. They were going to decide with anybody that they had. So,
too many people talking.
Yeah, I think that's probably.
You guys, hello?
Probably requires an ordinance for her to sign this request for a permit for that additional extension.
Okay.
For the village. This is a change order for the gravity collection to add 316 feet of line. So I had to put, EPA made me put an additional plan set together. It's just 3 pages. So we probably need to vote on that. I can show folks what it is. Is that how you want to do it? Or?
Okay.
Yeah.
Because it would require Vicki's signature to get this processed.
And I just want to tell you right now that the sheriff and the highway patrol are patrolling Mifflin, and they are going to cite anyone on a four-wheeler or golf cart or anything like that.
Are you allowed to ride a bicycle?
Yes, you are. Yes, you are.
Even though it's not licensed?
Yep.
Doesn't have
motorized.
So what's the right story? That's exactly contrary to what you told me 2 hours ago.
Right. But I got a phone call from the sheriff, and that's what he had told me.
Okay.
Any opinion of the solicitor?
Chapter 75 says it's illegal to drive them on the roadway. You can cross the roadway, you can't drive on it. It says right in Chapter 75 of your basic code that you just adopted.
But you can drive alongside the road, right?
You can drive alongside the road as long as it's
not in the road or anybody's property.
There's certain provisions in Chapter 75 that says what you can and can't do. I'm just telling you, generally, you cannot drive a four-wheeler on the road unless you're just crossing it. You can't drive it on the road. There's certain exceptions, but I'm not going to go through 15 exceptions and explain it to you.
It's in Chapter 75. The problem with this whole thing is, for the last 15 years, both of my quads have been used for village work. And now the village is telling me I can't put them where I took them to do stuff for the village.
It's always been in there, Mark. It's always been in there.
Yeah, and you're changing the status quo as of today.
Nobody's changing the status quo.
Yeah. It's always been the law. It's just been overlooked.
No, it can be allowed by a township, a village, a city, whatever. You are changing what the status quo is.
You can't go against what's in the Ohio Revised Code.
You don't have to enforce it either.
It hasn't been enforced for the last 15 years.
Right.
Now it's being done.
Right.
No, but now it's being done.
What is the difference?
We've got to follow all ethics and all laws.
Excuse me. What are we going to do about the dogs that are running loose then?
Start trapping them. I don't shoot them. You know, it's up to JJ and the sheriff and the state patrol to enforce the laws of the village.
Because it's only right to do. I'm sorry, Dave.
I'm sorry, I'm done. Go ahead.
People are allowed to park on alleys now.
I'm just saying, I have a list this long of stuff my four-wheeler did for this village. And now you're telling me I can't get it out of my house. And it's all come to a head because of one personal problem.
No, Mark, it's
been going on.
Yeah.
It's an ongoing problem.
People all,
well,
I mean,
wrong.
It's been extended.
We have never done that.
You're not doing work on four-wheeler.
No,
one person
earns a lot of money. I'm being banned from using one.
A lot of people have not, and it's sad.
Taking a look to the township house all the way back. It's not 1 o'clock
well,
in the morning.
Okay, let's get back on it.
I'm saying at 1 o'clock in the morning, 2 o'clock.
If you want to know what you can do with your four-wheelers or bikes or whatever on the roadway, read Chapter 75. I think there's 3 copies out there, huh, JJ?
So do we need to set something up to take care of these dogs that aren't staying on their properties?
Don't you just call the dog pound?
The dog warden.
Dog warden?
Yeah. Hold the cow. It took 2 days or a day for the contract.
I mean, isn't that the legal thing to do, though? The dog running loose?
Well,
call the sheriff.
You usually try to do things the neighborly way. That's usually how
right.
We try to do things.
So then you call the dog warden, then the sheriff, then the state highway patrol. You don't call your own police.
You think of the people to be doing slow.
No, she did. What about the phone number before you adjourn?
What phone number?
phone numbers so that if there's a problem with the light, the phone number, we can get all of those and stuff like that.
We need to get your phone number listed.
You want to write it down, Mark?
No, I mean, it needs to be out the newsletter. Posted. Phone numbers are listed with who's in with each department. If you have a problem, then you know who to get hold of.
Yeah, we have an address, and mine's the only one that's ever been in the village newsletter.
I brought that up.
Okay, well,
2 years ago.
Everybody's phone number will be put on there.
Call. Right.
Does anybody have a problem with the phone number being put on there?
That's not
Pam, does anybody have a problem with the phone number being put on the newsletter so that everybody knows the phone numbers?
No, I don't. Okay.
I brought that up 2 years ago.
Okay, but do you have a problem with that now?
Well,
we're talking about right now. Do you have a problem with that right now, putting your phone number on there for your committee?
Yeah, that was lucky. Everybody on the council should have a phone number.
Okay. Do you have a problem with that being put on there right now?
Your phone number being on the letter.
Okay.
I have a problem with it.
But there's too many people talking.
Do you?
They don't need your
Okay, let's do. Excuse me. Hello. Let's get back to the meeting here. We need to do the ordinance. Don't want to be here all night.
We don't have an ordinance. You just have to do the motion, and then we'll have to follow up with a resolution next meeting to confirm it.
Okay, how?
Man, that's the best I can do.
We'd like to get it submitted right away, but let's get this finished. Then she could sign it next month. Or could you?
She didn't sign it. They just can't pass a resolution because I didn't know you needed one. Had I known you needed one, I would have had it ready tonight, and they could have passed it tonight.
Well, it's kind of better.
I understand. I'm just telling you, they can't do a resolution tonight. All they can do is a vote. So if they want to do the motion to approve the change order, they can do that, and then we can follow up with a resolution next meeting.
Okay.
Is that what you want to do?
How do we have to do it to make it right?
Is that what we're doing?
When are you going to be back with your equipment to do that?
Monday.
Can't do it that quick, though.
I mean, we got witnesses.
We got to at least get their knock that they're going for.
We have quite a few laterals. We don't have all the laterals.
Okay, let's...
I'll make the motion to approve the changes that he needs pending resolution for next meeting.
Pam, second.
Yep.
Roll call.
Lori?
Yes.
Jesse?
Yes.
Deb?
Yes.
Dan?
Yes.
George?
Yes.
Pam?
Yes.
Okay.
So she can sign this so I get it submitted, or we got to wait till next minute? Okay.
Okay, do we have a resolution to adjourn? Can we get approval of the report?
It's right there.
Do we have a motion for the approval of the reports?
So moved. Which reports are we talking about? The financial reports?
Yes, let's do it.
Okay.
Second.
Wait.
Debbie did first, right?
Yes.
They're down there now. Second. Pam seconded. Roll call.
Lori?
Yes.
Jesse?
Yes.
Deb?
Yes.
Dan?
Yes.
George?
Yes.
Pam? Hey.
Yes.
You guys? Hello? The minutes?
I'll motion.
I'll second.
Roll call.
Lori?
Yes.
Jesse?
Yes.
Deb?
Yes.
Dan?
Yes.
Oh, abstain.
George?
Yes.
Pam?
Yes.
Okay, current month bills. Pay the current month bills.
Motion.
Roll call.
Lori?
Yes.
Jesse?
Yes.
Deb?
Yes.
Dan?
Yes.
George?
Yes.
Were you going to abstain again?
Yes.
Darn it.
What? She doesn't have to abstain.
No,
she said she was going to. She missed it. We have a motion to adjourn.
Motion.
Second.
Roll call.
Lori.
Yes.
Jesse?
Yes.
Deb?
Yes.
Dan?
Yes.
George?
Yes.
Pam?
Yes.
What's that in your chair, Jeff?
It's around there. Did you find out about the easement, the double corner? Didn't I send you an email? I can't find it. I can't find it in my pile of easements. So I emailed you and asked you if you have a copy or something.